دكتورة ماجستير.
اوكي. جود مورنينج.
جود مورنينج دكتور.
I am Dr. Marwa. I am senior house officer in the outpatient clinic today. I would like to confirm, are you Mrs. Sara, 30 years old?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, we are here today to discuss some issues related to your medical condition. Is that okay with you?
Yes, please, doctor. Yes, thank you.
Okay. I received a letter from your GP stating that you have fatigue and also problem in your period. Yes. Could you tell me more about that?
Yes, doctor. I have this problem after start now 3 months now, doctor. After my delivery, I lost my period and also I feel fatigue all the time, doctor.
Okay, I am sorry for that.
Yes.
Okay. This problem started directly after delivery.
Yes, doctor.
After how many days from delivery? Almost after how many days?
After the period, doctor, I stopped all my period, doctor.
Okay. This condition, this tiredness started suddenly or gradually?
Gradually, doctor.
Okay. Is it this constant or became worse?
This amenorrhea, doctor, there's no bleeding, no period. But fatigue increased, doctor, with time increased, doctor.
With time increase. Okay. Yes. Is your tiredness or fatigue have any journal variation or all over the day?
All over the day, doctor. I feel fatigue.
Okay. Okay. This you have any problem of that you have with this tiredness or fatigue? You are feeling that if you are standing from sitting position, you have dizziness?
Yes, doctor. I feel dizziness.
Okay. Are you having any craving for salt intake recently?
Salt intake?
Yes.
What do you mean, doctor? I can't understand what you mean.
I mean that you are feeling craving for salt containing food.
No, doctor. No.
Okay. Okay. Do you have any high body temperature?
No, doctor.
Okay. Any pumps or lumps in your body?
No, doctor.
Okay. Did you notice any mouth sores?
No, doctor.
Any change in your skin color?
No, doctor.
Okay. What about did you notice any neck swelling?
Yes, mild swelling, doctor, in my neck case.
Are you feeling some pain in this swelling?
No, doctor.
Okay. Okay. Do you have recently any cold or heat intolerance?
Yes, doctor. I can't tolerate cold without.
Okay. What about your weight? Any changing recently in your weight?
Yes, doctor. I have weight loss, doctor.
How many kg?
About 5 kg.
Over how many months?
And then from the start of problem, doctor, after my delivery, 3 months. Doctor.
3 months, okay. Did you change recently anything in your diet or in your physical exercise?
No, doctor.
Okay. What about your bowel motion? Are any changing recently in your bowel motion? I mean,
decreased,
motion or hard motion?
Decreased, doctor.
Decrease. And the heart?
Yes.
Okay. What about you are feeling of dryness in your skin?
Yes, later, doctor, than before, yes.
Okay. Any hoarseness in your voice?
No, doctor.
Okay. Any problem in your breathing? I mean, shortness of breath?
No.
Okay. Okay. After delivery, you have a problem. You failed to lactate your child. I mean, you tried to lactate your baby.
Yes, doctor. I try, but I can't.
You can't lactate. Okay. I'm sorry for that.
Yes.
Okay. What about your period? You told me that you have amenorrhea.
Yes.
Before this problem, before your period was regular?
Yes, doctor. Normal.
Was normal.
Yes.
And at that time before this problem, you have any problem that there is more bleeding with your period?
No,
or was normal?
Normal.
Normal. Normal bleeding and normal frequency.
Yes, doctor. Yes.
Okay. Okay. This is your first child, Mrs.
Yes.
Sara.
Yes, doctor.
Before you have any problem of miscarriage?
No, doctor.
Okay. Okay. Do you have any headache?
No, doctor.
Okay. Any weakness of any limbs?
No, doctor.
Any problem in your vision, clearing vision or?
No, doctor.
Any problem in your peripheral vision?
No, doctor.
Okay. Do you have any pains or needles in your body?
No, doctor.
Feeling?
No.
Okay. Do you have any cough?
No, doctor.
Okay. Any noisy breathing?
No, doctor.
Any lower limb swelling?
No, doctor.
Okay. Any skin rash?
No, doctor.
Okay. What about your water work? Do you have any problem in your water work recently?
As well, doctor.
I mean a change, increase in the frequency or?
Yes. Yes, doctor. Increase, doctor. Yes.
Okay. About, okay, and any sensation, thirsty sensation you are feeling with
yes,
this
I
frequency?
Feel, yes, doctor. Yes, I feel this time I increased to drink, I want to drink out of water, doctor. Same before.
Okay, what about, do you have any pain during passing your water work?
No, doctor.
Any change in the color? I mean, any blood or dark color?
No. No, doctor. No, doctor.
Okay. What about your Mrs. Sara? Do you have any past medical problem?
No, doctor.
No. Do you have any medications? You are taking any medication?
No, doctor. I take no.
Very good. Any past history of admission in the hospital?
No, doctor.
Any past history of any operations before?
No, doctor.
Okay. Any past history in of the similar condition in your family?
No, doctor.
Okay. Any family history of cancer?
No, doctor.
Okay. What about your job? What do you do for life?
I am teacher, doctor.
Okay. How much this problem affecting your work?
As I told you, doctor. Last 3 months, I had fatigue and cannot tolerate any work. So I took a lot of sick leave, doctor.
Okay, I'm sorry for that. I will refer you to occupational health worker to help you in this issue. Is that okay with you?
Thank you very much, doctor.
Welcome. What about your, are you smoking?
No, doctor.
Okay, are you drinking alcohol?
No, doctor.
What about driving? Are you driving?
Yes, doctor.
Okay. And you told me that sometimes you have dizziness, okay, and some problem in your if you are standing from sitting positions. Yes.
Yes.
So I advise you to stop driving until full treatment is giving for you and the proper treatment for your condition. Is that okay for you?
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you for advice. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Okay, Mrs. Sara. Okay, I would like to ask you, Mrs. Sara, during this dizziness attack, you are feeling that you are awareness of your heartbeats?
No, doctor. Normal. No, doctor.
Okay. No. No blackout or something
no,
during
just dizzy. No, just dizzy.
Okay. No sweating or something like that during the attack?
No, not.
Okay. Then, Mrs. Sara, what's your concern?
Yes, please, doctor. I want to know what my problem, doctor.
Okay. Most likely from the history I took from you, and also I need to complete the history with the full examinations and also to do some blood tests and some images. Most likely you have a problem in your gland. There is a gland like a maestro of other glands that controlling also secretions of certain proteins from it, which are called hormones. Most likely this gland is suppressed, most likely by a decrease of obstruction of the blood conduit that is reaching this gland. And for that, most of other glands are affected. And this is the cause of this problem.
Yes.
And this gland is called the pituitary gland. And it's controlling any most of the glands in your body. So most likely, most of the gland affected and causing this symptom. Okay, are you following me, Mrs. Sara?
Yes, yes, doctor. 2 minutes remaining. Okay. Yes, doctor, I
agree. Okay, do you have any other concern, Mrs. Sara?
Yes, doctor, I wanted to know, what's the plan? What's the plan? You're give me tablets or give me injection or what?
Okay. Most likely, yes, we will need to do some blood tests to confirm our diagnosis, including that we... this tests will include the level of the hormones in your body, and most likely we will start to replace this suppressed hormone to act in your body and to be replaced. And most likely we will start with cortisone because we will start first, and after that we will start to replacement of other hormones.
It's okay. Thank you very much, Dr. Marwa. It's okay. Discussion with examiner. What's your differential diagnosis, Mrs. Marwa?
Okay. Most likely, this condition is panhypopituitarism.
Yes.
It is. This condition is most likely post delivery. May be due to, infarction of the pituitary gland.
Yes.
Infarction in the pituitary gland and causing this suppression of other hormones. This is my first differential.
So okay. So what's the cause of infarction?
The cause of as this patient don't have bleeding after.
You ask. Don't ask. Don't ask. It's okay. Doctor before. Doctor before. It's okay. She has no bleeding. So okay, no problem. But type. Yeah, your differential diagnosis. First differential diagnosis is.
And I think pituitary infarction is.
Yes, pituitary infarction, but no bleeding. But no bleeding. No bleeding. So okay. Maybe, another differential diagnosis.
Postpartum thyroiditis.
Postpartum thyroiditis.
Thyroiditis. It started with hyperthyroidism, and after that started to be hypothyroid. As manifested in the patients by this constipation and also fatigue and cold intolerance.
What's the cases of the? What's the fatigue? What's the cause of fatigue?
Fatigue. This one is fatigue. Is most likely the diagnosis panhypopituitarism, and this is manifestations of adrenal insufficiency that yes. causing this problem.
Yes.
This
yes.
Fatigue and dizziness and so most.
And lactation. What's the cause of lactation? Cause of lactation.
And also related to gonadotrophic, this prolactin also suppressed because this yes. is panhypopituitarism. Yes. So all the glands yes. are affected, thyroid affected, and the adrenal insufficiency, and yes. also and also prolactin and
excellent yes. This,
and also hypogonadism leading to problem in her period, yani amenorrhea.
It's okay. So we are now okay, we are with you with panhypopituitarism. I with you, it's excellent. But what's the cause of panhypopituitarism? This is the point of the aim of this case. The point was the causes of the panhypopituitarism. It's okay, no problem, doctor. Doing excellent, Dr. Marwa. Type. So, what you are doing this patient management of this patient?
First, we will do a short synectin test.
basic investigation.
Basic investigation. Yes, basic investigation first. Yes, complete blood count and the ESR, CRP, and we will do also thyroid function test. And also short synaptic test to detect adrenal insufficiency and the prolactin hormone level, and also FSH, LH, and also I think all hormonal profile should be done.
What about polyuria? What you are doing?
For polyuria, yes, most likely this. Diabetes insipidus?
No, because ADH also part of ADH from the pituitary and water deprivation test. Water deprivation test from the ADH. Exactly. Yes. It's okay. So the most manage what's the treatment? It's replacement.
Replacement, but we should start with cortisone first, and then after that start replacing of another hormones.
Doing well, Dr. Marwa, excellent, very excellent. Yani, now it's the differential diagnosis, it's bile hybridism, but I know the cause of this bile hybridism, I know it's difficult. I know it's a very rare cause, but it came in one case in the exam. I know, but it's very difficult. Yani, it's very difficult, I know, but if you reach about bile hybridism with the examiner, it's excellent. But yeah, something missed, we'll discuss inshallah. We are finished with Dr. Marwa, doing very well. Anyone has any comment, any question, not ask Dr. Marwa, not ask it, you want to comment? Anyone before I will comment?
Sorry, Dr. Khan, is it proper to ask about any source in a private place like syphilis? May syphilis cause hypopituitarism? It is rare, but maybe.
Syphilis. I think you know Dr. Muhammad, not effective here, yani syphilis. What's the syphilis benefitism? It's difficult, Dr. Muhammad. Difficult, yeah.
It's possible, but difficult.
Very, very difficult, yeah. It's okay.
Sarcoidosis is also possible, but also rare. Yes. Sarcoidosis.
Yes. Okay, so okay, one differential diagnosis. So, Dr. Marwa, what's your differential diagnosis you are put before the station, Dr. Marwa?
Okay, I put first Sheehan syndrome, but it's more common if there is postpartum bleeding.
Okay.
And also after that, I put pituitary infarction, but I was searching for the cause that like blood clotting, blood problems or something like
excellent.
Yes. So hypopituitarism, this is my...
The main, it's okay. Thank you, Dr.
Okay.
So any other doctor has any comment before we start? It's okay.
Sorry, doctor, for investigations, do you think better to do MRI for pituitary before any investigation?
Of course.
It is the first, it should be first before hormonal assessment.
Of course. MRI is very important, yes, and also the hormone replacement is very, very important, bone level, very important also. Very important, both, yes. But here from our
definitive... pituitary apoplexy?
Father Dr. Mustafa.
What about pituitary apoplexy?
Yes. Can you remember us, Dr. Mustafa, what's mean about pituitary apoplexy?
It means sudden hemorrhage in the pituitary gland in a patient with previously known pituitary problem or pituitary adenoma.
Excellent. So it's hemorrhage or infarction in the patient has pituitary tumor. It's okay. Or pituitary adenoma. So you have to ask about the pituitary adenoma. Doctor asked about headache and visual disturbance. Okay, so she asked about neurological symptoms. So I have done neurological symptoms. Excellent, but you are very, very important in pituitary apoplexy for different challenges. Excellent, Dr. Mustafa. Okay. But you have if you find neurological symptoms, it's okay. Very important.
Okay.
So any pituitary adenoma is a cause. Pituitary adenoma with infarction or hemorrhage in the pituitary adenoma. So it's called the pituitary apoplexy, as Dr. Mustafa told. But you have to find. Help you with find neurological symptoms. Okay, so if you want to, if he want from you pituitary apoplexy, he will push you in the neurological symptoms. But Dr. Marwa asked me about everything about neurological symptoms, visual and headache symptoms. There's no problem here. And conscious visual disturbance. It's okay, but no symptoms here. So I know it's يعني not easy, not easy case, I know. But يعني all you are thinking about banhepatism, if you reach about banhepatism, I think very excellent. And Dr. Mustafa added the total abobixone of the French diagnosis, very excellent. But I help you today to find the rare case. And you can't find in يعني, easy, but I help you to how to think in this case. It's okay. So, Bismillah, we'll start now with comment in this case. So our case today is Mrs. Sara is 30 years old female, present with amenorrhea and fatigue in the last 3 months after delivery first baby. So before the station, you think in the case of the amenorrhea. Amenorrhea very very important. Amenorrhea and fatigue. So you have to in the very very important amenorrhea. You ask first, and you have in the first sheet, you ask about is amenorrhea start with after delivery. So it's secondary amenorrhea, not primary amenorrhea. So is mostly amenorrhea from the pituitary. Very very important. Pituitary is very very important. So you have to think in the causes may happen after in the pituitary after the delivery. The most important as very important pituitary apoplexy, very very important. It's okay. Maybe non-functional pituitary adenoma, and maybe mass in the pituitary gland, non-functional pituitary adenoma, or pituitary apoplexy, or Sheehan syndrome, very very common. Because may come in this case, very common in any case. Sheehan syndrome, very important. Maybe infiltration of the pituitary gland. This is the point here. In some cases, infiltration of bone in the pituitary gland by three cases. Sarcoidosis, very very important, and hemochromatosis, because the iron may be deposited in the pituitary, cause pituitary deposition, and something called lymphocytic hypophysitis. Lymphocytic hypophysitis, I know it's very rare, but it come in one exam. So you have to ask about hemochromatosis, very very important. And ask about sarcoidosis because maybe infiltration in the pituitary gland and in lymphocytic hypophysitis. I know these three cases, no one ask about it because it's very rare, but not one care about hemochromatosis, sarcoidosis, and lymphocytic hypophysitis. The most common one after that. So after the delivery, what you think after the delivery, you think about Sheehan syndrome, pituitary apoplexy, and lymphocytic hypophysitis. After the delivery, specific for after the delivery, is three things. Think about the pituitary apoplexy, Sheehan syndrome, and lymphocytic hypophysitis. Very, very important. So, Dr. Marwa doing excellent in the start. I am Dr. Marwa. Today we'll discuss your condition. I will write some confidential. I write some notes. It's 100 confidential. It's okay, doctor. So please inform me what happened to you. Yes, doctor, I start to have fatigue and stop of my period after my delivery, my baby, first baby, about 3 months now. I am really sorry about this, Mrs. Sandy, or Miss Sarah. So, can I ask you some question? Yes, doctor. What about? Can you give me, a problem now? No one ask about the what happened in the delivery. You have to ask about more about the delivery and his pregnancy. You ask about the problem now in pregnancy and in delivery. You have to ask more about the pregnancy and delivery. Please, can you tell me about your pregnancy? Is normal pregnancy? Yes, doctor. Any problem during pregnancy? No, doctor. You have to know, is it cesarean section or normal vagina? Normal vagina, doctor, as Dr. Muhammad asked. So ask more about the delivery. So about pregnancy, any problem happening during the delivery? Very important, Dr. Marlos, and not ask about is any severe bleeding during the delivery? No, doctor. You have received any blood transfusion? No, doctor. So you ask about your pregnancy and the delivery. Normal pregnancy? Yes, normal pregnancy. Any bleeding during the delivery? No, doctor. Any blood transfusion during delivery? No, doctor. Is normal delivery or cesarean section? Yes, normal, doctor. So, okay, so now you cover first point is delivery. You ask about delivery and pregnancy. Now you ask about the pituitary gland. You are concentrated in the pituitary gland. What the you have to ask about the pituitary gland? You have to ask about the hormones, T3, secreted from the pituitary gland to know what the complication was here. Very, very important TSH. Very important TSH. ASTH. ASTH is cortisone. So it's called corticosteroid. Growth hormone. Very, very important growth hormone deficiency. LH and FSH and ADH. And the prolactin also. So TSH, ADSTH, and GH, growth hormone, and LH, FSH, and ADH. So you have to ask about the hormones affected from the gland. TSH, you have to know, is if TSH is affected, so it causes hypothyroidism. It causes hypothyroidism. So you have to ask about everything about the hypothyroidism. You have to ask about the weight gain, about your any change in your weight, any weight gain, cold intolerance, any constipation, it's okay. Dry skin. What about you have any neck swelling or neck swelling? So I have to ask about hypothyroidism because it decreases TSH. It's okay. Another one, an ASTH. ASTH, so corticosteroid. So decrease STH will decrease the cortisone, will cause Addison disease. As in this case, the patient have any weight loss. Yes, patient has weight loss with dry skin and with cold intolerance and constipation. So patient has something from the hypothyroid, is cold intolerance and constipation, and something from the corticosteroid is weight loss. So you need weight loss with cold intolerance and constipation. What how this is pituitary, not in the not in the hypothyroidism. It's okay. So loss of weight, this is pill. Any pigmentation in your skin or no, and getting sick in the abdominal pain, this Addison disease. Growth hormone deficiency, also growth hormone can cause fatigue and muscle weakness and decrease of concentration and intolerance to any exercise. As in this case, also. So the patient has TSH deficiency and the ASTH deficiency and growth hormone deficiency. And very important also LH and FSH, how to ask about LH and FSH, about the sexual desire. You have, as Dr. Muhammad asked, you have any, this I can ask a private question. Yes, doctor. You are lost your desire of your sexual. Yes, doctor. I have decreased sexual desire and I have some painful or problem in my private relationship with my husband. So, okay, so the patient has painful relationship. So very important to decrease sexual desire. Very, very important, LH and FSH. And also ADH, also. ADH very important, so you feel has polyuria. As Dr. Amar asked, very important amount, change your amount, and feeling thirsty. So decrease ADH. And also prolactin, very important. I can't feed my breast milk of my baby. You have now covered every hormone from the pituitary gland. Very, very important. After you ask about hormones, you ask about the causes. First, as Dr. Mustafa asked about pituitary apoplexy or any adenoma or any mass, as Dr. Muhammad asked, mass in the pituitary gland. You have a mass, no mass without neurological symptoms. So you ask about headache, you ask about visual problem, and has any loss of conscious or disturbance conscious or numbness or weakness. So okay. Double vision, visual disturbance, any vomiting, because headache and vomiting, this intracranial hypertension. Very important, this pituitary apoplexy or non-functional pituitary adenoma. Very, very important. And Sheehan syndrome, as we asked before, they had asked about severe bleeding or blood transfusion during delivery. You ask, sure, Sheehan syndrome and the pituitary apoplexy and the infiltrative causes. No, but I know infiltrative causes, usually not ask, anyone not ask, was very, very important. You ask about sarcoidosis. You have to ask about any skin rash in your shin, and you have joint pain and hypercalcemia, so abdominal pain or pyuria, especially pyuria, and maybe changing mood because depression causes hypercalcemia. Sarcoidosis is very important. So sarcoidosis is skin rash, joint pain, pumps or lumps, shorts of breath or cough because has chest symptoms. And also hemochromatosis, ask about diabetes, and ask about tummy pain and tummy distension and liver problem, yellow discoloration, diabetes and tan skin, all this hemochromatosis. And also last thing is lymphocytic hypophysitis. I know it's very, very rare, but come in exam,
lymphocytic hypophysics, our case, lymphocytic hypophysics. I know a lot of us, as me, yani, not heard it before. It's a condition, this condition happen in the after pregnancy and post delivery. It's okay. Due to autoimmune condition. It's autoimmune condition due to infiltration of the pituitary gland with lymphocyte. So the pituitary gland can infiltrate by hemochromatosis in the iron or in sarcoidosis, or three things is lymphocyte, is lymphocytic hypophysis. So infiltration of the pituitary gland with lymphocyte is autoimmune condition. Very, very important, and it came in one exam. So okay, you have to think in this. So you are now asked about the hormones and asked about the causes. Now we ask a general condition about CNS, as we told, the headache, visual disturbance, sleep weakness, any numbness, uncontrolled water work or habits, CVS, very important, any chest pain, heart racing, leg swelling, shorts of breath, pulmonary, bardo, cough, any cough history of blood, bleeding per nose, so okay, change in your bowel habits, change your bowel habits, any acid brush, any mouth sores, any swelling your abdomen, it's okay. It's okay. Generally about change about your color, you think about the purine, it's okay, no problem. The sexual history, ask about the menstrual, ask about you have male birth or menstrual, menstruation is female or period, you ask about before this problem, it was normal, as Dr. Omar asked. For now, this problem is normal, yes, doctor, regular. Has any problem before? No, doctor, it's okay. So ask about diabetes and have any chronic disease. You take any medication, very important, any surgical operation, any hospital admission before, any drug, خلاص. What's your work? How much affect this work? I will help you do social work, and smoking and alcohol, very important in traveling history. So can I summarize what's your discussion about the data with you, Dr. Mrs. Sandy? Yes, Dr. Mrs. Sarah. You inform me you has amenorrhea and fatigue after the delivery. You and also has weight loss and cold intolerance and constipation and polyuria and have sexual problem or sexual decrease sexual desire and can not lactating your baby. It's okay, you, Mrs. Sarah? Yes, doctor. So what's your concern? My concern, doctor, what I have, what's my problem, doctor? I need to as I told you, Mrs. Sarah, we need to examine you and we'll admit you for more investigation. Mostly for our discussion today, you have problem in your menstrual gland. It's called the pituitary gland. It's very important gland in your brain, which secretes a lot of hormones. Any problem in this gland can affect secretion of hormone. So mostly this gland affected by some, one problem called, may inform the patient, not inform me, as you told, problem in the gland, it's enough with patient, but you can inform with examiner, it's okay. But you can inform this mostly after the delivery, this gland may be infiltrated by some, like some, by lymphocyte, multiple lymphocyte or some, maybe, has problem in deposition or some problem deposition or infiltration of the gland happen after the delivery. It's okay. So we need to admit you and doing some investigation. It's okay. And doing some scan to be sure about our diagnosis. It's okay to you, Mrs. Sarah. Yes, doctor. Has any, you have any, ask a question again or any question? No, doctor. So with discussion examiner, what's your differential diagnosis, doctor? Is differential diagnosis, doctor, is most of this patient has benign hypothyroidism, as Dr. Sara is very important, benign hypothyroidism. What's the cause of benign hypothyroidism, doctor? Mostly due to lymphocytic hypophysitis. This doctor is one of autoimmune condition, mostly occur after the pregnancy or late of the delivery. It's autoimmune, this lymphocytic infiltration. Another cause, doctor, must be Sheehan syndrome, but against this doctor, there's no bleeding. And also maybe pituitary apoplexy or pituitary adenoma, non-functional pituitary adenoma, but also doctor, there's no any neurological symptoms or any pressure symptoms from this mess. So my differential diagnosis is mostly is lymphocytic hypophysites. So what's your managed plan? I will admit the patient. And we're doing some investigation, CBC, basic investigation from of CBC, RVT, LVT, and ESR selective protein, and just X-ray, ECG, this is basic. And specific, we'll do hormonal assay or hormonal assay in the form of TSH, LH, FSH, ADH, prolactin, and STH, and estrogen level. And for polyuria, we're doing water deprivation test for ADH, and the growth hormone tamale is for important growth modification, and doing MRI brain for bitter. So what's your management? So pharmacological and non-pharmacological. Non-pharmacological is psychological support and patient education and the counseling and occupation and replacement therapy for the hormone defect. I know today is case is not easy. I know it's common, not common, but I my job or my advice, I can help you in this. This not usual. If I bring it to an usual case,
I think if you help you to concentrate in the abnormal thing, I think it's be good. Yeah, it's okay. This case of hypothyroidism, maybe come easy. Moses, it's okay. Maybe Shan syndrome, maybe a bit of a big spot. You know, have to know the multiple differential diagnosis to, inshallah, in the exam to catch it early, inshallah. It's okay. It's helpful for you. It's okay. Anyone has any comment or any thing they can understand? It's okay. Are you right, doctor?
Excuse me, doctor. What is the treatment of lymphocytic hypopituitarism? What is the
nothing.
Treatment?
Nothing. Replacement therapy. Replacement therapy. It's okay. As infiltration, as hemochromatosis, everything. Are you right?
Doctor?
Are you right? Fadal, Dr. Amway.
I have a question. This deposition of lymphocyte, it will affect, like, it will cause headache, vision problem. Should we ask about this or
not? Yes. You have to ask because you have to exclude the mass symptoms. If they have the mass symptoms, you have to have neurological symptoms. It's okay. But with the physical condition, you do not have neurological symptoms as a mass, as pituitary apoplexy or non-functional pituitary adenoma. It's okay.
Okay.
Yes, and you have to ask us in general. You have to ask in general neuro. You have to ask everything about general neuro. I will write to you because someone, doctor, asking how to write. Lymphocytic hypophysitis. It's okay. Lymphocytic hypophysitis. This our case today. I know it's not easy, but inshallah will help you. It's okay. We take a lot of time in this case. I know. It's okay.